Hey, what's up, everyone? Driving a car, everything went well this morning. So once Dan got to the shop, you know, the mech, the Lexus Master Tech, he and I, you know, we got the car on the lift, we got under it, we figured out what was going on. Another gentleman on the Lexus forums let me know that he bent his linkages gently to get them out of the way, and that's kind of what it's probably going to have to be, unless you can find some other type of adapter plate to slide it over, which would have to be machined and factored into the cost of the drive shaft even. So what we did is, I'm going to put a little of the pictures of it, but what we did is took the middle console out and from the top looked at it and see what we needed to do. Instead of taking the car, obviously dropping the exhaust, or at least I got the, I have the PPE header back exhaust section. I have the, actually I have the whole set, PPE headers, and I got the whole exhaust system from PPE. So we could have took that one section of pipe off to make some more room to clearance, for clearance to work with. But what it became was, we needed to bend that linkage safely without putting any pressure any elsewhere on the internals of the shift, mechanism. So took it out the middle console, which is fairly easy, and took that whole piece out, got it onto the bottom angle portion of it on a vise, and just closed the vise a little bit, and that bent, opened the angle up to move the linkage out of the way. And then we took on the rod, the connecting rod that goes into the transmission, we took that small piece off the end of it where it connects directly to the linkage, and we bent it inward to account for the angle, the bend that we put in the top linkage piece. So again, I have a picture with sent to me from another ISF owner with arrows pointing to the two spots that were bent and what needs to happen for now. So that got us to the finish line. So doing those two bends, getting everything back together, test drive is going well. Right now, I've been able to leave Jasper, Georgia, drove to Oxford, Alabama, which is about 100 miles, and then a little more than 100 miles. And then now the drive back from Oxford, Alabama, I'm going to Jonesboro, Georgia. So these are 100-mile drives. So car's fine, no problem. I'm trying to watch the gas mileage. I'm trying to stay in normal mode and not obviously being in sport mode all the time worsens your gas mileage. So I ain't trying to, you know, run with anybody or hot dog this shit on the street. I don't beat the hell out of the car that way anyway. At least, you know, I go to the track. I'm a novice on the track days right now, so I'm nobody special to damn beat the car up, you know. And I don't drag strip the car, so I don't have intentions of that from a dig, pushing the car that hard. So at least not this one. So that being said, it's holding up fine. I don't hear it. Nothing's connecting. Nothing's coming in contact. You know, no abnormalities, no excessive vibration. Again, the drive shaft on the highway is smooth. It's quiet. When I need to accelerate or pass a car, it does it with no effort because it's our car and we know what it is. So the install went good. So all in all, just going back, you know, I did email James the picture, James at Sicky. I emailed him the picture, told him what we did, what the success was. Maybe they'll make some instructions for it. Maybe they won't. They'll at least do something, because he said I was the first one to call him. I can't imagine that I was the first guy nationwide that bought this drive shaft for an ISF. You know, if nobody else had, I'm not even complaining. I'm like, hey, do you have something better that's permanent that you can tell me to do? You know, looking for guidance. So nonetheless, he did say I was the first one to call him with this issue. So they're looking into it, and then what's probably going to come of it is that hopefully they'll make some printed instructions, at least a PDF file that explains that middle console piece, or the linkage itself needs to come out and get fixed so it bent appropriately, or some kind of adapter to push it over or whatever. So that's that. If you have any questions, feel free to comment on a thread, or shoot me an email or something. You know, if you mind it and you got questions. I did, again, post it in the Lexus ISF owners. Lexus space ISF space owners space Facebook group. So that's the only one I'm in. I'm not in the RCF IS groups, the GSF, RCF, ICF, none of those. I'm not in those combo groups anymore. It's discussion enough to talk with guys in this one. So that being said, I'm enjoying my drive shaft. There's a lot of people, or a number of people, who were against, getting rid of the rubber greebles and, oh, you're going to tear up your diff. Well, that's my choice. And so if I beat the shit out of the ring and pinion and it needs a new one, that gives me, hey, I'm going in there anyway. So I am going to upgrade my internals on my diff. So so I got everything else RR Racing, the motor mounts, the steering response system, the damn radiator, ECU tune, PPE, full exhaust, DC Racing coilovers. I'm running the engine intake. I should have got the damn RR Racing intake, the whole package. I was trying to piece it together and save a couple bucks here and there. That was not the smartest idea. So I should have went with their intake, with their tune and their headers, and then finished piecing everything else together that way. But lesson learned. So I talked to Simon at RR, and he's like, you won't get me. I even went and bought a MAP housing that's the same measurement of their mount housing. So I have their carbon fiber elbow, I have the MAP housing, but then I said, hey, will you sell me just a heat shield and intake, the air filter? And like, nah. So I have to find someone with just a heat shield, and that will go for this car. And if I can find just a heat shield, or fabricate one, I can use my carbon fiber elbow with my billet aluminum mouth housing that's the same diameter as theirs. So in the meantime, I have an engine intake on here right now. So I know the two-stage closed box is better. There's the debates about that, but either way, my gas mileage, because I do these kinds of drives, is what matters. My gas mileage is actually better with the intake, because I'm not hot dogging it when I'm out here. That extra airflow makes a difference in the number of miles I can get on a tank. Literally a night and day difference. So either way, hope this is helpful for everyone, and be seeing you on the road.